And the Wings won the Stanley Cup that year. It was the last year anyone won the Cup other than Montreal for five. Hyman charging to the net. Couldn't lift the backhander upstairs.
Just ran over Smith, too. And he's coming out of the net. He's not too happy about it. And everybody's going to come in here. This could get ugly.
Chasing after Ilya Mikheyev. No meaningful punches exchanged just yet, but Mike Smith, a fiery competitor.
Yeah, he didn't like that. It was Hyman that came in from the right-hand side, drove it through to the backhand, and just kind of went through, and Mikheyev was driving too. But he certainly got bumped, and he's a big guy. Mike Smith doesn't go down too easily, and right here you see it's Hyman that catches him high and catches him in the helmet. And I don't think it was intentional whatsoever, but obviously frustrated the way this game's going. He was getting shoved a little bit by Jones, and he just had to try and fight for that inside space. And
shot, big save there by Bobrovsky. Suter sends it towards the front of the net. It's loose, and then it kicks to the corner. Bobrovsky lost his mask as Foligno was right around that net.
Well, that's how Bobrovsky got shaken up there a couple of weeks ago. It was the same kind of play, collision deep in the crease. Bobrovsky loses his mask. Suter just put it off the end boards. He knew that the redirection was going to come out in front, and you see the bodies just flattened. Foligno right out in front. There's the hit on Bobrovsky.
Vidlitsky to Tavares. Strome shoots. That changed direction. Comes off the end boards. Then Bangin, and the goaltender's without his helmet. He is complaining. The referee emphatically indicating it's a good goal. No doubt this will be challenged.
Supposed to call it, but if you don't see it, how can you call it? There's the wrist shot from the side, and there's his helmet gets, I think he knocked his own helmet off, and it gets into the net along with John Tavares. Watch the goaltender. Let's see how his helmet comes off. He's in front of the net. Look at this. Oh, look, yeah, at this. Oh. That's garbage. That should not. I don't know if the NHL can do anything about that, but that is garbage. He was out of position, and he wanted to knock his own helmet off. That is terrible.
Haglund using his speed, bouncing puck. Oh, big collision. And it's going to be a penalty called on Haglund. And then he gets roughed up afterwards. But I don't know what. I have to tell you, I don't understand. That was both players, the goalie going for the puck, Haglund going for the puck.
I'm not sure, and now they're going after Haglund. I'm not sure if it wasn't the defenseman that got most of the contact. His own defenseman is the one who hit him.
And he turned also. I don't know what they expect of Haglund.
Watch the defenseman
here
on the left side there.
And out in front, it's taken away, picked up now, and Leguan dishes it down the ice, and here's a race for it, and going after it with Foligno, and he crashes into the goaltender, and Hutton jumps back onto his feet, and so does Foligno.
He's flattened him twice, and right here, Hutton comes out, rolls the dice to play the puck. Marcus trying to play it as well, and it was a tie. But look at Hutton, he just flies over the top of Marcus Foligno, and down he goes.
I'll take Max Domi, and he brings it in. Domi to the net! Oh! And boy, that time he went right into Curtis McElhaney.
That is a collision. Oh my goodness. How about the wheels of Max Domi, and McElhaney is still not sure where he is. He thinks he's back in Columbus right now. Look how far out he is. Takes a hit right on the button.
Yeah, and he
and his defenseman is there. That puck, I think, might trickle in, if not for his defenseman. But my goodness, he cracks the back of his head on the ice after his helmet comes off.
They try to get the pass through to Steen. It got there eventually. Shattenkirk with a shot. Knocked down. Schwartz, a swipe at it. A chance here. Dubnyk, not sure where it is. The puck's behind the net. And Dubnyk is in the net.
He got knocked over backwards and his mask came off. That's why the whistle was blown. And then he gets set up again from the close in play. See, he does a great job with the blocker to make that save. And then when he goes over backwards, his mask just comes right off. And as soon as the goaltender loses his mask, they blow the whistle down. Stastny pushed him backwards a little. And when he went back, he's not happy about it.
The independent arbitrator reducing his suspension. Look at Orlov skip in there for Wilson. He scores! Tom Wilson on the board.
Welcome back, Big Tom. It's like an extended training camp for Tom Wilson. He spent 40-some days on the sidelines. Dubnyk's banged up after taking the thrust of that hit after Wilson had already put the puck into the net. And he was rumbling as fast as he could to drive the net. How about Dmitry? Look at Orlov's first period. A goal and then this pinpoint accurate pass right on the doorstep. Notice Suter could not control 43. Tom Wilson gets inside position. Size works to his advantage. And there's a beautiful shot. And it's a wipeout after the goal that knocks down Dubnyk. No harm, no foul. 2-0 Caps.
He's bleeding right to the left side of his eye.
Now there's the collision. It was Andrew McQuaid. Adam McQuaid colliding with Tim Thomas. Watch Thomas as he gets knocked down. I think this puck gets airborne. And as it comes back to the front of the net, does it hit Thomas square in the face? Boy, I think it might have. I think that puck changed direction and then hit Tim Thomas.
The way his head jerked back.
Yes, it did.
That sure did.
Boy. This is one of the more dangerous plays we've seen all season long. This is last night. Vancouver Canucks taking on the St. Louis Blues. Jake Allen's mask comes undone. It's not on his head anymore. He puts it aside, but the play doesn't stop. The officials don't notice. Jason Megna actually gets a shot off on Jake Allen, who is livid. Marty Brodeur can't believe it either. Mike Yeo, Blues coach, was on Hockey Central talking this afternoon.
Philadelphia zone. They will go and take away the D-to-D play now. They will come with two forecheckers.
Here's a chance out to challenge Hedberg.
His jersey's over his head and his mask is off.
Oh, my goodness. Wow.
No, we're good. You okay?
You hear the referee saying, are you okay?
Tacoma.
This is fearless. Now, you've got to get rid of it. But look, where?
How do you get rid of it when your jersey's over your head?
That's like pin the tail on the donkey. You're blindfolded. Find your way back to the crease, Moose.
Where's the pinata?
Oh, my goodness. Toyota Tacoma play the game, but some fearlessness on the part of Johan Hedberg.
Niederreiter to Haula, who carries in. Haula works his way to the net on the backhand. Oh, and a save by Lehtinen, and then Haula. We'll hear about this one as he collides with the Dallas goaltender. Did he ever steamroll Lehtinen on the end of that play? Haula go to the net, and he just keeps going. Looks like he lost an edge right as he got to the net, but he did not make any effort to get out of the way. Oh, looked like the back of his foot got hooked a little bit on the defenseman as well, but either way, he ends up just bulldozing Lehtinen, cuts him because of the impact. Lehtinen is out of the game, and Haula gets a five-minute major and a game misconduct for charging.
Used to it having worn the full mask in college, and the vision is pretty good. Said not too bad.
Yeah, there are areas, right? Yeah.
And, Lundqvist was knocked down.
There it is again. Lundqvist there. Boy, that is a hard hit. He had plenty of time. Look at all the time he's got. And then he lifts up with the shoulder directly into the head of Lundqvist. You wonder why he stayed down? That's it.
Wow.
That's a hard hit.
Final minute of play in the first. Back they come. Gaudreau for Leek up front. Gaudreau passes. Chance. Monahan. Stop. Rebound for Leek. Kicks at it. Russell shoots. And Holtby makes the save. That looked like it was going between his legs. It may not have counted because he'd lost his mask.
Up ice quickly. Johnny Gaudreau is just going to dangle around. And what a save by Holtby. Now you can see Holtby loses his mask right there just before the Russell shot. Listen to the whistle here.
Great stick. Knocked the puck down. Jason Spezza's long reach. And oh, what a collision here. Mrazek got run over by Kyle Clifford. And we're
worst case scenario for the Carolina Hurricanes, the trainer's on the ice again to look at a goaltender, and already one goaltender's out of the game.
Yeah, I'm not sure if you can really blame Clifford on this one. This is a race for a puck, and he's focused on getting there. He's going, trying to get after the puck. He's focused on, and all of a sudden, there he is. Mrazek going after it, wasn't just trying to stop and make the play. He tried to follow through. Look at the goaltender. Oh, he's trying to make a shot with that puck. And yeah, I don't even think that Clifford's really even looking at the goaltender, but that is one heck of a hard collision. The mask came off, and you've got to hope that Mrazek, who's come in relief and played really well, settle things down.
Ovechkin moves down that opposite side this time, denied by Dumoulin, regains though, Dumoulin without a stick. Here's Ulster, save made by Murray, and he grabs on. And now the helmet is off and a crowd again, and then Murray crumples down.
He lost his mask and he got hit right in the head with a shaft to the stick. Ulster got a great opportunity coming in, the nice feed by Alex Ovechkin. There's a shot, Matt Murray stares it down, makes a save. Stick comes up, Ulster goes in, Malkin doesn't like it. And the helmet comes off, the mask comes off, and then watch, the stick comes in right there from Malkin. His own teammate gets him right in the mouth.
Marc-Andre Fleury is getting his equipment, his goalie mask on. All the rest of his equipment is ready.
Goes in behind the net. There's Skinner trying to get free. Skinner takes a shot, deflects it right in front. What a save by Enroth! Oh, lordy! He robbed them blind, call a cop. My goodness.
Without a helmet on. And they still didn't blow the whistle. He makes this, could be the best helmetless save in the history of the NHL since they started wearing a mask.
King's own shot is knocked away by the goaltender Quick, whose mask got knocked off, and the whistle blows.
Jonathan Quick is perhaps asking the referee how the mask come off. May have been the puck. Get the Kings going one way, shoot back against the flow. Briere's there with a stick, but I think it was the puck that hit the goaltender's mouth.
Vanek, his shot. Here's a breakaway now, and the puck gets away from Lucic, and Miller gets hammered by Lucic, and Lucic is getting a penalty. Miller's down on the ice, and they ought to clean his clock. He took a dead aim at Miller.
After Miller beat him to the puck and shot the puck into the sideboards, he was leveled.
That was not an accidental collision.
It sure wasn't.
That was as deliberate as you can possibly get.
Charging, they're going to call it.
Two minutes. Charging.
And I hope Miller's all right, but he took an awful wallop, I'll tell you that. Lucic is a big guy.
Longest they've had in Vancouver in a long time since Henrik had one in 2013. Smith out of his net is wiped out behind the goal, and we got something going on now.
Everybody separates. Here it is here as Edler gets in aggressively on the forecheck. There's Smith, and he just kind of comes through and gives him a bump. Helmet goes flying. He wasn't too happy when he got up too, but did the right thing, went back to the net instead of going to the scrum. No question of penalty.
Balk inside Versteeg. He'll dust it off, across it goes. Hope he got a piece of it, and it's sent wide by Versteeg. As Skinner had a great chance, Balk shot. Holpe's down, blown dead, injured on the play. No mask, that's automatic. But heavy traffic, a little disturbance now to the far side, and you see how incensed Braden Holpe is.
When a player's in danger like he clearly was, to absolutely blow the play down. Now there's your first backdoor chance. What a chance, what a play by Ulster. Versteeg tried to bank that in. That could have been goaltender interference, certainly, afterwards. Come, no, he got pushed in. Absolute good non-call. But when he loses his mask, regardless of why he lost his mask.
Aaron will settle, feed it up top. Dubois, nice moves around Dowd. Centering pass that's just out of the reach of Panarin, and there's a whistle here.
Yeah, Hopi's mask got knocked off right in front of the net. The referees, I think, are going to signal a minor penalty coming up against Columbus.
A few moments ago, Braden had the mask on as it was Anderson threatening him. 1-0 Columbus. Capital netminder a few moments ago tangled up with Cam Atkinson in front.
Man, this is dangerous looking big time. There's the stick of Atkinson right going right through the eye hole of the mask of Braden Holtby. His mask comes off. There it is. It wasn't on purpose. He was trying to get positioning in front of the net, and his stick catches the mask as clean as day. And Holtby's still being looked at as that blade right through the eye hole, Joe.
Backhander right off the drop. Pavlik takes it in the chest, loses his mask, and that should bring the automatic whistle as Pavlik knocks that one down high. And neither referee saw that the mask was off. Play is to be stopped immediately when a goaltender loses his mask. And John Anderson is asking the question now, what is going on?
Good on him. He stuck with it. And I don't know if... here, you see the pile of players, and his mask comes off, and I think the referees are looking at the puck, and this one comes up off his shoulder, and luckily did not hit him in the cheekbone or whatever, because I'll tell you what, that will do some damage, but good on him to stay with it. Great job.
Stayed with him all the way.
Lundqvist may have gotten a piece of that shot. Fedotenko bumps with Bergeron. Oh, a high shot knocks the mask off. Hard shot by Brad Richards. Caught Rask in the mask. And play stops immediately as the goaltender's mask comes off.
Krejci, and then listen to this one.
Oh, Derek Stepan will try to move it along, but he can't. Turnover, they score! Oh, Kings have scored, and Darcy Kemper
is
on the ground.
Down and in a ton of pain. Totally accidental. Here's Lewis. He's going to backhand it. And then it's on the follow-through. He gets hit from behind right there. He gets pushed in to Darcy Kemper by Kevin Connaught. The whole time his stick is right in the eye hole.
Through the screen was Varlamov. Kucherov again. Let it on back. Return pass bounced over. Kucherov a shot, and that one fought off and then held. And the helmet mask comes tumbling off. And a disagreement at the front of the net, of course.
Should be 3-1, but the Islander netminder has been up to the task. This last one catches him in the mask, which undoes the buckles, and the mask eventually comes off. But how about these saves? Pass across to Palat.
There, gets away from Pete with his speed. Moves in. His shot. And a collision there with Elvis, and Elvis is in some difficulty.
Trying to catch up now. Elvis pokes the puck. Oh, so he hit the top of his head on the post. Take a look at this. He pokes, he's going to lose his helmet. Oh no, he got his helmet back. Okay, so his helmet was still on when he hit his head on the ice. But that's not much of a helmet. There's just a back cap on that back part of it.
This first period. Half David Perron cutting in. 199 NHL goals. He caught Anderson, who's in some difficulty after that.
That shot hit him directly in the mask, and you could tell the way that he stopped for a moment that it gave him a little bit of a shake.
And that zapped him.
A sharp angle for David Perron, and Perron's it. Trying to go short side high. There's nowhere really to go with the puck, so he's trying to squeak it over the shoulder of Anderson, and it catches him right in the mask. He shakes it off, and the play shakes the mask off, and the play stops immediately.